Hi, and welcome to Accounting Academy. I'm Fitz, and this is my dog, Fifo. We love to help people learn more about accounting, so join us on our adventures as we dive into accounting topics. On today's adventure, we are going to be helping our friend, Laine. She's considering buying into a new line of business. She has some questions about how to determine if this is an asset acquisition or a business combination, and what is a business. Hey, Laine.
Hey, Fitz. Hey, Fifo.
We heard you're expanding your business.
That's right. We're expanding from just collars into leashes as well. We're acquiring a small leash manufacturer. While they're a business, it doesn't really feel like we're buying a full business, since what I really want is their lease-making machinery.
Okay, so how can we help?
There's a lot of new guidance, and I'm having trouble determining if this would be an asset acquisition or a business combination. It would also be helpful just to refresh me on the accounting for both.
Sure. Well, let's start with the basics, and then we can run through your scenario. So to start, I'd like to note that the guidance has been updated as of January 2017, when the FASB issued ASU 2017-01, titled Clarifying the Definition of a Business. The easiest way to think of this is that if you meet the definition of a business, then it's probably a business combination.
And if it doesn't, then it would be an asset acquisition.
Yeah, that's mostly true. A lot of times it will be fairly obvious, such as buying a machine to produce leashes is probably an asset acquisition. But if you're buying a well-developed business who already makes leashes, it's probably a business combination.
Okay, but should I go through the guidance to make sure it's not a business?
Yeah, it's good to go through the guidance at ASC 805-1055-5A-5C. This guidance gives certain screeners for when a purchase might not be a business combination. But let's go through the basics of how the guidance defines a business first.
Okay, I think I remember there are three items: inputs, a process, and outputs, right?
Yep, those are the three. But I will note that the new guidance does state that the outputs are not necessarily required to be considered a business. For example, an early stage company with no revenue.
Could we go through what each of those really are?
Sure, let's start with the inputs. The guidance defines inputs as any economic resource that creates or has the ability to contribute to the creation of outputs when one or more processes are applied to it.
So in my situation, this would be the machinery that I'm purchasing.
Yeah, that would qualify. Okay, so the next is a process. This is defined as any system, standard, protocol, convention, or rule that would be applied to an input or inputs that creates an output.
Okay, so in this case, the process would be the company that we are acquiring's business process. They have steps to convert inventory through the manufacturing process to create leashes.
Yep.
Okay, and the outputs are the final leash in this case.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay, and how does the accounting differ for both an asset acquisition and a business combination?
So, if it's an asset acquisition, the purchase price or cost would be allocated across the assets paid for, based on their respective fair value. If it's a business combination, all assets and liabilities acquired would be fair valued and recorded at their new valuation. This could result in goodwill being recognized or even a bargain purchase gain.
Oh, that sounds complicated.
Yes, it can be. I would recommend the expertise of a fair valuation expert to assist.
Okay. Well, thanks, Fitz. I think in my situation, it feels like I'm acquiring a business. I'm acquiring inventory and cash with the purchase of a large machine.
Yeah, it definitely has inputs, i.e. the machine and inventory, processes, i.e. the manufacturing process already set up, and outputs, the leashes.
Yeah, it does feel a little odd still because most of the value is just that one machine.
Well, there is one bit of other guidance that may be useful. This is substantially all screener that is part of 805-1055-5A. This guidance basically says that excluding cash, substantially all assets' fair value is within one asset, and it does not meet the definition of a business.
Okay, but what is the threshold for substantially all?
Good question. This is a bit of a gray area. Some firms have said 90% constitutes substantially all, but judgment will need to be applied.
Oh, then I think I qualify for this exception, and we would be an asset acquisition.
Great.
Okay, but can we quickly go through my entries?
Sure. What are the details of your deal?
So we purchased everything for $100,000. The machinery is on his books for $70,000, but it's worth more than $95,000. We're also getting $1,000 in cash and $9,000 of inventory.
Okay, well, cash and inventory cannot be booked at an allocation cost exceeding fair value because they are financial assets. So those will come on the books at $1,000 and $9,000 respectively.
Okay, but what about the machine?
Well, in this case, you will allocate the remainder of the cost to this single asset.
So $90,000?
Yep.
Easy enough.
Yeah, not too hard of an example.
Thank you so much, Fitz. I really appreciate you walking me through all the basics. And of course, you too, FIFO.
All right, folks, thanks so much for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. And if you can, donate to Patreon. Anything you can give helps to keep the lights on and ensures we can continue to create content. And of course, helps feed FIFO. If you want to contact us about anything you saw in this video, accounting advice, or ideas for future videos, contact us at patreon.com/accountingacademy.
This video is designed to be illustrative and does not represent an official position. We make no representations, warranties, or guarantees and assume no responsibility for the application of this material. Please seek advice from a competent professional if expert assistance is required.